Everyone, Happy New Year. So I just want to share what are the New Year tradition of Filipinos and Danish. First, Filipinos, we like to wear polka dots. Polka dots clothes, it's important. Yes, in the Philippines, they believe that all rounds like polka dots, if you wear something polka dots, rounds are signs of money. So they also collect different round fruits, like I don't know how many, 12 or something like that. So the more round fruits, the more money. It's like you're inviting money. The round ones are like symbolizes coins, you know, or money. So that's the Filipino tradition. And yeah, of course, a lot of food, a lot of noise. And in Philippines, yes, you could see a lot of fireworks everywhere. So kids, from kids to adults, I had experience when I was a kid, I was playing with fireworks. So yes. What else are Filipino traditions? Some of the Filipinos, if they are small or they are not so tall, they jump at 12 midnight before the new year or at the new year, because they believe that if they jump, they will grow. So yeah, so some of them jump if they wish to grow taller. Okay. In Denmark, there's not so many fireworks because it's so expensive to buy fireworks here. And if they do, you know, even those who don't fire fireworks, they have protective glasses. And kids are not, you know, it's not so common here that they allow kids to play with fireworks, no. So they're protective with their kids, and yeah, and they don't have that much. I mean, it's not so, there are still some who have fireworks, but it's not so common in all streets. It's like, yeah. So, and Danish have tradition, I think in clothing, I noticed they like glittery, so that's why I have this last year, glittery, and this is actually polka dots. I don't know if you could see it, but it's polka dots. So it's like a combination of Danish and Filipino tradition. And in Denmark, they always wear hats like this. This is my daughter's New Year's hat. Yes, they wear whatever hats. Whatever hats is accepted. Could be with 2019 or whatever hats. Whatever you could put on your head. I don't know what's the meaning behind those hats. So those are I think they also eat cakes. Danish eat cakes, this specific cake when it's 12, and of course the champagne toast. Just always champagne toast. Yeah. And they also have always every new year, Queen Margaret makes speech every new year. And yes, it's the cake name is Kanse cake. Yeah, like it has those like white sugary sweet. Yeah, and they always have, you know, they have this in TV, they play Admiral von Schneider, or this is every year James. It's like, this is like a drunkard, what do you call this, waiter, or bar. Yeah. Yeah, it's like he always offer toast, and at the end he's the one who's getting drunk because he always get all the toast. Yeah, that they have like those movie traditions or what they normally watch during New Year. Yeah. And there's also Prime Minister who's also doing speech. So both Prime Minister and Queen Margaret do speech every New Year. Yes. Those are the Filipino and Danish tradition. In Filipino, we say Manigong Bagong Taon. That means prosperous New Year. In Danish, we say Godt Nytår. That means Happy New Year. So, Happy New Year to everyone. This is 2019, so I hope that you will all be blessed this year. Bye.